Rachel, and you're watching TRAX TV on channel 25 in the windy city of Chicago. You know all the great house music, Move Your Body, Can You Feel It? New stuff like this goes out to Ron Hardy and Gina Triple X, where you can get everything from TRAX Records, number one label in house music on iTunes and any digital store that you can think of. Watching TRAX TV on channel 25 in Chicago, and you may have been seeing these very interesting spots about adventure, and you might have been wondering, what is Bob Mack Fitness all about? So tonight I have a special guest with me, and that is Bob Mack.
Hi Rachel, thanks for having me. I'm really glad to be here. Love TRAX Records, love the things you do, and I love you as a client.
So, Bob, I wanted to ask you, how did you get into the business of adventure fitness?
So, it's funny. I never really meant to come up with something called adventure fitness. At one point, about 20 years ago, I just wanted to lose 20 pounds. I worked as a software engineer in the financial markets for 25 years and spent a lot of time in front of a computer programming. Loved my job, but didn't really stay in shape. So, I put a little excess weight on that I wasn't happy about. So one day I decided to start exercising. So I tried everything. I'd go down the elliptical trainer and do 2 hours on that, and I'd starve myself, and I did everything wrong. And then I hired a trainer, and the trainer I hired really didn't have experience as a trainer. He knew how to get himself in shape, but he knew how to get other people in shape. So I wanted to learn how to get myself in shape.
So, Bob, on your road to this whole, like, personal fitness thing, what were some of the steps that you took to learn how to get yourself into shape?
So, I interviewed a lot of trainers that I have known over the years, and I asked them how they got started in personal training. So, one friend of mine named John, I really had a lot of respect. He really just seemed to know a lot about kinesiology and body mechanics and how to motivate people and how to control weight. Told me he got certified through the International Sports Sciences Association. So I started with that certification first. After there, just like I did with my first career, I started to gather other certifications. Right now, I'm currently working on my 9th one. Most of them are in fitness, but I have some in sports medicine. I've got a couple in TRX training. I'm a certified Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu instructor, and I'm also a certified Commando Krav Maga instructor. So this year I'm studying a new one. It's a certification in fitness nutrition, which is basically how to maximize your workout by eating right.
So now that I've learned a little bit about your disciplines, and just from my own experience of training with you, I want to know a little bit about your self-defense training courses and what those are like.
Yeah, self-defense is definitely one of my passions. When I started to get into shape, I felt very confident and I had a lot of energy to do things I've never done before. And one of them was to study Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. We've all seen the UFC where these amazing fighters are fighting. And I've done some stand-up work like boxing and Muay Thai, but I had no idea how to do any ground fighting. So at the tender age of 54, I went and signed up at a Jiu-Jitsu academy over on Michigan Avenue. I meant to do that for 6 months, but 7 years later, it's still a passion of mine. And I do it whenever I can. Jiu-Jitsu gave me the confidence to take on a lot of the other challenges after that. I started running marathons. I started mountain climbing. I just kept bigger and better challenges as I got older, actually. So one of the more current ones is I just finished climbing Mount Kilimanjaro. But before that, I started to study a martial arts system called Commando Krav Maga. And between Commando Krav Maga and Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, I believe those are the best two self-defense systems. The world is changing. You've seen the news. You know what's going on as well as I do. I don't like to dwell on it. I don't worry about it, but I think we need to be aware of it. So in terms of self-defense, anybody that's even in good physical shape becomes a harder target than somebody who's not in good shape. Bullies look for weak people to take advantage of. They don't look for strong people. And that's whether you're a male or female. A strong-looking female is not going to be as much of a target as a female that's maybe a little frail, looking at the ground, looks frightened. So all my exercise programs, I kind of sneak in a little self-defense. I even have some geriatric clients that are in their 80s, and we do punching drills where I hold up mitts and they will punch. Now, I'm not actually teaching them to be fighters, but I'm teaching them to use that physical and mental connection, which helps slow down the progress of dementia and Alzheimer's.
So mountain climbing, especially climbing Mount Kilimanjaro, now that sounds particularly challenging. Can you tell me a little bit about what that experience was like?
Yeah, Mount Kilimanjaro. I just came back from that a couple months ago, and that was really an amazing adventure. Mountain climbing hasn't really been a long time passion of mine. I always wanted to see Africa, but the way I got started in mountain climbing is I had a client on his bucket list was to climb Mount Rainier, the tallest mountain in the contiguous United States, just under 15,000 feet. And he said, would I go with him? I said, sure, why not? Like I said, my fitness system gave me this energy and confidence to do just about anything so far. And so we went and we climbed that mountain, and it was a lot of fun. It was quite different, but it gave me a taste for mountain climbing. I still wanted to see Africa, so last year I decided to do Mount Kilimanjaro. Mount Kilimanjaro is the tallest mountain in Africa. It's one of the seven summits in the world, and it's 19,341 feet. There's a couple different routes. There's the Coca-Cola route, and then there's the whiskey route. Whiskey route, like it may sound, is harder than the Coca-Cola route. I chose the whiskey route because I wanted a little more challenge. So it was 5.5 days up. We climbed, slept in a tent, and a day and a half to get down. The temperature ranged from 85 degrees on the bottom to about 5 degrees at the top, and it was very demanding. The last summit day, we had about 16 hours of activity, 7 up and then about 8 coming down, and we burned about 30,000 calories. And it really pushed me to my limit. And on my way down, I was questioning, why do I do this kind of stuff? What motivates me? What drives me? And the short answer is it feels really good when I complete it. So I thought about it, and for 6 of the people, I did Mount Kilimanjaro. Next year, we're gonna do Mount Elbrus, which is the tallest mountain in Europe and in Russia. So that's my next challenge in terms of mountain climbing. So you can call me directly at 312-407-7997. You can also reach me on bobmacfitness.com, and that's got links to my Facebook site, my Instagram, and all sorts of ways to contact me. But again, that's 312-407-7997. I hope to hear from you soon.
My best friend, and that never ends, never ends. treat you like a superstar. For I love you and that is what you truly are. Come true. Sister, sister, does he promise he will marry you? Sister, sister, does he treat you like a superstar? For I love you and that is what you truly are.
Hey, baby. You're being awfully quiet now. You weren't like that at the club.
Space Placers, you're in the right place for the queen of house. All the way from Chicago. She's hot. She's happening. She's hip. She's hype. She's here. She's screaming, Rachel!
Place to be loud! This is the best place!
We're going to rain on you vampires.
That's what's up.
We are the house. We are the house of love. We are the house. We are the house of love.
Tell you something, Captain. With all due respect, I'm not gonna be second anymore.
I didn't have a son, but if I did, it would be you, because I'm proud of you.
That will be done on Earth as it is in heaven.
Hello, this is the rapping lawyer speaking. Who is this? He did what? Say what? Why we'll sue the bastard.
He's the one with the love of clouds. Rapping lawyer.
I'm the rapping lawyer from way downtown. You can come to me when someone puts you down. And for a very reasonable fee, I'll rap for you. I'll set you free. I'm your main man in the city. So if you're busted, well, I know it's a pity. You just come to me for your mouthpiece. And from that moment, your trouble will cease. Your style's not even criminal. Dealing with me still won't be minimal. But if someone has done you wrong, like say they've stolen your very best song. And if over them you want to master, you come to me and we'll screw the bastard. Please help me out. I know you're the finest. I know you got clout. Please, won't you help me out of this mess? Why I'd do anything, cause I know you're the best.
I got 1,000 people all want me. The only way to choose is to charge a fee. If you want a piece of my time, then lay the tall green on the line. Cause I'm a rapping lawyer. We'll sue them federal, we'll sue them state. We'll sue them in a way they can relate. And then we'll do the thing they'll really feel. Well, take them up on appeal. And after all this, if they still retort, why hell, we'll take them to the Supreme Court. When I'm standing by that old time nine, you'll hear me say, you'll hear this line.
Your honors, permit me to introduce myself. You see, I'm the rapping lawyer from way downtown. People come to me when someone puts them down. For a very reasonable fee, I'll rap for them. I'll set them free.
You'll sue them federal, you'll sue them state. You'll sue them in a way they can't relate. And after all this, if they still retort, why hell, we'll take them to the Supreme Court. Rapping lawyer,
he's the one with a lot of clout.
Rapping lawyer,
he's the one that can help you out.
I'm Screaming Rachel, and you're watching TRAX TV on channel 25 right here in the beautiful windy city of Chicago. Now every day people ask me, where can I get one of those fabulous TRAX t-shirts? And it's really very simple. If you follow TRAX Records on Facebook, all you have to do is press the shop button and you can get all kinds of cool customized TRAX merch. So it's very simple to do. It'll come right to you. All you have to do is press shop on our Facebook and you can get your very own TRAX t-shirt. Black, white, red, whatever you desire. I'm Rachel Kane. And I'm passionate about youth communication. A 40-year-old nonprofit whose mission statement is youth must be heard and understood. We give teens an outlet through the longest running teen newspaper in the country, New Expression. Having a creative outlet allows teens to let out their angst, allows them to go towards having healthy minds, put down their guns, and become a family. We feed them, we empower them, we mentor them, and right now, Chicago needs your help more than ever. We hope to become a beacon for not only our city and our country, but for all of the world. Now think about these two words, youth communication.
Thank you. step on Beethoven's fingers, you make the poet stall. You break the child shelter's cry to break in once again. You trample on the flower, you do it just for fun. There's such a beauty waste in your world. You shut down, you maim, and you kill the only ones that make sense. You kill the only ones that make sense.
How much is the beer?
How many you want?
Don't scream, Rachel.
Rachel says hello.
She's filming right now.
Yeah, I don't know. There's an issue with that. Screaming Rachel says hello.
Uh-huh.
Corey says hi.
Hi.
Yeah, there's an issue with the remote.
I don't know. What's your name again?
Crystal.
Crystal's doing all the makeup, making us beautiful. Crystal, you need to make me beautiful. I don't look like a wreck here. Okay, I'm gonna have a seat. I need this.